kids, good morning. Oh, today we are going to study in our student's book. Please prepare your student's book. Student's book, page 90. Student's book, page 90. Please open page 90. I am waiting for you. Let's learn. Today, we are going to learn some information about measuring. Did you hear about it? Measuring. What can it be in Turkish? Measuring. Measuring, ölçü, ölçmek. Okay? What can we use measuring? Or where can we use measuring? How can we use measuring? Let's learn together. We measure things to find out how big they are. Ne yapıyormuşuz çocuklar? Biz nesnenin ya da bir şeyin ne kadar büyük olduğunu öğrenmek için ne yaparmışız? Ölçümleri kullanırmışız. Okay, look at the picture. But firstly, I want to give an example. This is my house, okay. And we need two things for measuring. What are they? Do you have any idea? What are they? Number one is height. Okay. And number two is length. We need height and length for measuring. Okay. I told you this is my house and here is length. Here is height. Okay. Here is length, here is height. Yani çocuklar, burası benim evimin boyları, burası uzunlukları. O zaman height ne demekmiş çocuklar? Yes, boy. And length? Yes, uzunluk. Okay? Uzunluk. Height is boy. Length is uzunluk. Okay? Look and read. Write A or B. Look at the train. Height. A or B? Yes, line B is height and line A is length. Good job. We measure things to find out how big they are. We can measure height and length. bigger, small things. Ne diyor çocuklar? Biz küçük nesneleri, küçük şeyleri ölçmek için santimetreleri ve milimetreleri kullanırız. Her santimetrenin içinde 10 tane milimetre vardır. Bir cetvel küçük nesneleri ölçerken bize yardımcı olur. Let's use it to measure the length of the pencils. Okay, look at the picture. As you see, pencil A is 5 centimeters long. Pencil B is 5 centimeters and 7 millimeter long. Okay. Çocuklar. Bakın 6.3 santim diye yazıyoruz. Fakat okurken 6 centimeter point 3 millimeter şeklinde okuyoruz. Okay? We write this and 5.7 centimeter. Okay. Write the length for pencils C and D. Pencil C is 8.9 centimeter. Okay. Pencil C is 8 centimeter and 9 millimeter long. Okay. And pencil D is 14 centimeter and 2 millimeter long. Please write the pencils longs. Use a ruler to measure things on your desk. Okay, you can measure your rubber, pencil, door, window, bed. Okay, you can measure whatever you want. Okay, page 91. Student's book, page 91. Read, look and measure. To measure big things, we use meters. There are 100 centimeters in 1 meter. A tape measure helps us to measure big things. Let's use it to measure the children's heights. Jane is 1 meter tall. Ollie is 1 meter and 25 centimeter tall. How tall are Nora and Jim? Ne diyor çocuklar? Biz büyük şeyleri ölçerken metre kullanırız. Her 1 metrenin içinde 100 tane santimetre vardır. Okay? Ne diyor? Bir şerit bize büyük nesneleri ölçerken yardımcı olabilir. Tape, şerit, okay? diyor. Hadi bakalım diyor. Çocukların neylerini çocuklar? Boylarını ölçelim. Bir şerit kullanarak çocukların boylarını ölçelim. Jane ne kadarmış çocuklar? 1 metre. Oli 1 metre 25 santim. Okay, what about Nora? Nora is 1 meter and 30 centimeter. Okay? And Jim is 1 meter and 45 centimeter. Please write kids' heights. Okay. Jane is 1 meter. Ollie is 1 meter 25 centimeter. Nora is 1 meter 30 centimeter. Jim is 1 meter 45 centimeter. Okay. Okay, use a tape measure to measure the height of three friends. Or you can measure the height of your mom or your dad, okay? Guess and measure. Draw a table and write 5 things that you want to measure. Guess the length, height and write it in your guess column. Measure and write your results. Mesela çocuklar, neyi ölçmek istiyorsanız, kapı olabilir, cam olabilir, yatak olabilir, fark etmez. Neyi ölçmek istiyorsanız yazıyorsunuz, boyunu, uzunluğunu tahmin ediyorsunuz. Sonra ölçtükten sonra bakalım sizin ölçümleriniz, yani ölçtüğünüz nesneler tahminlerinize uyuşuyor mu, uyuşmuyor mu? Kendinize göre bir proje gerçekleştirebilirsiniz. Anlaştık mı? Okay, student's book, page 92. Page 92. Listen and act out with your teacher. Then listen again and number the pictures.
Student's book, page 92.
One. Listen and act out with your teacher. Then listen again and number the pictures.
One.
You're waiting for bus number 11.
Two.
It's starting to rain.
Three.
Open your umbrella.
4.
The rain stops. Close your umbrella. Look, here comes a bus.
6.
Look down. There's a puddle in front of you.
7.
Jump out of the way. Whoa.
8.
Too late. Flash. Oh.
Okay. Listen again and number the pictures.
Student's book. Page 92.
1. Listen and act out with your teacher. Then listen again and number the pictures.
1.
You're waiting for bus number 11.
Okay, you're waiting for bus number 11. Which picture is it? Yes, this picture is number 1.
It's starting to rain.
Yes, which picture is number 2? Yes, this picture is number 2.
3.
Open your umbrella.
Yes, this picture is number 3.
4.
The rain stops. Close your umbrella.
5.
Look, here comes a bus.
This picture is number 5.
6.
Look down. There's a puddle in front of you.
And this picture is number 7.
7.
I'm sorry. This picture is number 6. Look down. There is a puddle in front of you.
Jump out of the way.
Run. Yes, jump out of the way is number 7. This picture is number 7.
8.
Too late.
Flash. And this picture is number 8. Please number the pictures. Did you write? Okay, thank you. Read and number the sentences from the story. Yes, which sentence is number 1? Sheila is number 3. The rain stops. Close your umbrella is number 4. Look, here comes a bus is number 5. Look down, there is a puddle in front of you is number 6. Çocuklar, puddle su birikintisi, okay? Su birikintisi, puddle. And number 7, jump out of the way. And number 8 is too late, slush. Okay. Number the sentence from the story, please. Okay, kids, it's enough for today. See you next lesson. Goodbye.